with Martin Besser.
Dr. Francois Stofberg van die Efficient Groep op die lijn, asking questions about food prices. Dr. Francois, goeiemôre, hoe gaan met jou?
Lekker, dankie en julle.
Nee wat. Hoorie, ek dog ek check het gou met jou. Mense wat weet altyd, want ek weet nie wat my verbeelding is en of iets gebeur het oor nacht nie. Dit voel net vir my asof sekere kossoorte, certain foods have just, the prices have just shot through the roof.
Dit is so. Gelukkig net vir sekere goed.
Okay.
Daar is gewoonlik, soos ons weet, tomatiepryse wat so nou en dan opgaan, aardappelpryse wat opgaan. Ongelukkig elke jaar is die belastings toeneem, dan is dit al die sondekies wat die pryse duurder word. So ja, dus van tyd tot tyd is daar sekere gebeure wat plaasvind wat spesifieke produkte duurder maak vir ons. Maar oor die algemeen, maar daarom nie die story as jy na jou hele mandjie van goedere en dienste kyk nie.
So is daar sekere goed wat verbasend laag geblei het of afgegaan het?
Ja, precies. Ek dink jy, as jy dit so kan verstaan, dan maak het baie meer sin. Ons hoor altyd net die headlines van die een of twee items. En ja, van die graanprodukte, weet ek, raak een groter deel van ons sakke. Van die voedsel, wat stapelvoedsels wat ons eet, vir alles die prijse opneem, dan, of dramatisch toeneem, dan maak het ons redelijk seer. Maar oor die algemeen eindelijk, kostprysinflasie die laaste ruk besig om af te kom. En ek dink die reservebank het baie geld om mee, maar natuurlijk ook goed, soos die wisselkoers wat gehelp het, petrolpryse wat bietjie laer is, en die internasionale prys vir graanprodukte veral wat bietjie afgekom het oor die laaste jaar wat ons gehelp het. So hier en daar gaan ons 'n uitskieterproduk sien wat weer bietjie seer maak as ons na dit kyk, maar verbruikers is baie slim. Oor die algemeen kry verbruikers dit reg om een produk te ruil vir 'n ander produk en sodoende nog steeds te help om daardie begroting bietjie laer te hou aan die einde van die maand.
What is basically saying is I've been buying the wrong stuff.
Yeah, no more potatoes for you.
I have been shopping exactly those things that have shot up.
Yeah.
I should be looking around. Maar as it kom by vars produkte, though, I mean, so let's say you're not buying potatoes, but you're buying sweet potato or you know, something else, it still feels like it's unnaturally high.
Yes. Yes, I think that's the real story, is that life is expectant. It's very expensive, and it feels more and more expensive, and that speaks not, I think, to a larger story that of what we've been feeling in South Africa over the last couple of years. I don't think it's just prices being more expensive. I think life is tough, and it has been tough, and interest rates are high, and yes, inflation has been relatively high, but jobs, people are really struggling to get jobs. Wage increases aren't as high as they've always been. The markets haven't been performing locally as we've been used to. The rand has been under pressure. So it's all these factors, I think, that are really weighing down on South Africans and just making us feel like the pinch is a little bit too much. But I think really what we've seen now from the rest of the world, there has been a sentiment shift or a change in sentiment towards South Africa. So really good news, and I think it's going to look a lot better in the next couple of years.
So what you're also saying is salary increases have not been keeping up.
I'm saying that to your bosses, yes.
But you know what, and I do feel for people living way down below on a breadline scenario. I mean, it must be, sometimes for me when I see some salaries and you see the cost of living,
absolutely,
for me it's unthinkable.
Yeah. Think how.
I don't understand how.
Yes. Yeah. And it's never just one person that's also living off that salary. It's generally like your family, there's a family, there's more than one person.
Yeah, that must be really, really, really tough. Who eats a condenser? Yeah.
That is an unfortunate problem, a very unfortunate problem in South Africa. We've tried really to address that with social grants, which I know is not enough. And in terms of redistribution, support to poor families in South Africa, we have really done a lot. The World Economic Forum and World Bank published some research a few years ago to show that in terms of tax redistributions, in terms of support for poor families, South Africa has actually done of the most of any emerging country in the world. So we are really trying, but the only way you help, well, anyone for that matter, is to create more jobs. But the focus can't be job creation. The focus has to be economic growth. And the only way you do that is to create an environment that is conducive of growth. That's supporting private sector, freeing up trade, making it a nice place to come and visit for tourists, etc. So we have to do more of that. And I think the rest of the world is starting to expect that. With this new union that we do have.
So just in closing, there seems to be some positive news going forward for South Africans?
Absolutely, absolutely. You can already see it. The currency is really doing a lot better. There seems to be, in terms of confidence indicators, a little bit of a shift. And if you're around the braai, die nuus is nie meer net so negatief nie, so dit voel selfs asof Suid-Afrikaners dink dat daar 'n bietjie van 'n draai gekom het.
Lente is op pad. Bring it on.
Well
Dr. Francois, dankie vir jou tyd, waardeer dit.
Mooi dag vir julle, tot sien.
Bye-bye. Dr. Francois Stofberg daar van die Efficient Groep with some good news to what sometimes feels like just bad news.
This is Breakfast with Martin Bester, Jacaranda FM.